So we've all had a refrigerated moments here where it just boinks onto your head that you forgot your Fire TV stick remote along with your dongle, or just straight up lost it like tears in the rain. And now you're wondering how on earth would you connect your new Fire TV stick with the Wi-Fi without a Fire TV remote. So I'm Vamsi, and turns out that you can use your smartphone to control your Fire TV stick and connect it to your new Wi-Fi. And if you've lost your Fire TV stick remote and are in no mood to buy a new one, I'll show you how. That way you can use your Fire TV stick without a remote forever until you lose your smartphone and then you'd buy a new smartphone. Moving on. Before we begin though, we'll have to understand the problem first, so let's do that.
So the problem here is that we don't have a remote. So for that, we can use the Fire TV remote app from your smartphone to control your Fire TV stick. But it only works when both phone and Fire TV are on the same Wi-Fi network. And not to forget, your Fire TV stick is already set to work on your home Wi-Fi network, which obviously you did not bring with you.
So to get this thing to work, you'll need two things.
Two smartphones, one to create a hotspot and another one to control your Fire TV stick. As one smartphone alone can't connect to its own wireless hotspot for its network connection. You need to know the SSID and password of the last network you connected your Amazon Fire TV stick to.
Once you have both of them, it's pretty simple.
First, we'll use first device to create a hotspot and set the SSID and password of hotspot the same as your home Wi-Fi network, the one that Fire TV is already connected to. And then we can install the Fire TV remote app on the second phone connected to the old hotspot and use it to control Fire TV stick. Once we're able to control the Fire TV stick with the phone app, we'll easily connect the Fire stick to the new Wi-Fi network. So we've got two phones. On the first phone, we'll set up a wireless hotspot. You can also use the other device to set up wireless hotspot. However, since iPhone doesn't let you change your hotspot name, you'll either need a Windows PC or Mac or Android. Assuming you have an Android, go to Settings, Wi-Fi, and set up SSID and password the same as your home Wi-Fi network, the one that the Fire TV stick was already connected to. For this instance, my Wi-Fi name is Batcave and the password is Robin204. Obviously, your home Wi-Fi name would be different. The moment you start the hotspot, you'll notice your Fire TV stick will instantly recognize it and connect to the internet. Next, take out your other phone. If you haven't got one, just borrow someone's for a few minutes. This could be an Android or an iPhone. And then install and run the Amazon Fire TV app on that one. Once the app is installed on the second device, connect to the wireless hotspot you created in the first device, that is Batcave. Once connected, open the Fire TV Stick app in the second phone. You'll be able to see and control your Fire TV Stick listed there. You can go to home, move around using the touch, or even use the keyboard and voice control to type stuff. It's pretty cool. Now, the party's still not over. Remember, this is all running on limited mobile data. So to connect your Fire TV stick to a new remote, use the second device, navigate to Fire TV settings, and then network and connect to new Wi-Fi. That is wherever you're staying, like, you know, your home or hotel Wi-Fi. Once your Fire TV stick goes to a new network, you won't be able to connect it from the second device. But that's easy. Connect your second phone to the current Wi-Fi, the one that your Fire TV stick is connected to at the moment, and you're good to go. In case if it's a hotel Wi-Fi that requires username and password to connect to, you can do the same. Connect the second device to a new Wi-Fi network and use the keyboard and the app and then type in the username and password.
So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope this works out for you. Alternatively, if you've lost your remote and are in no mood to buy a new one, I mean like forever, here's what you can do.
You can also use a Fire TV remote from your friend for a few minutes, if someone has it already, and use that to set up your Fire TV stick to your new Wi-Fi. Pretty much all Fire TV stick remote works with each other, you just have to pair it once. So to do that, hold down the menu, back and left arrow buttons simultaneously on the new remote for 10 seconds, and then reboot your Amazon Fire TV Stick. This should connect the new remote with your Fire TV Stick, and then you can use it with your Fire TV Stick to connect your new Wi-Fi. Once that's done, you can return the remote to your friend. Just make sure it's unpaired. But how do you control your Fire TV Stick without a remote? Well, you can install the app on your phone, or if you have a TV that has an HDMI CEC, you can even use your TV remote to control your Fire TV Stick.
To set up Fire TV Stick with HDMI CEC, we've done a video on that, so give that a watch if you're keen on that. And give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And let me know what you think in the comment section below. Oh, by the way, if you don't know, we make videos on how to make the most of your streaming devices like Apple TV, Android Fire TV Stick, Chromecast, VideoShield TV, and whatnot. So I'm not gonna be like, please subscribe so you want more info on that kind of stuff. I know you will if you really like what we do here. As always, thanks for watching, and now that I've done a massive info dump on you, that doesn't sound right, go watch some movie recommendations that we've done, like movies like John Wick, Interstellar, and much more. Thanks for watching, see ya.